South African singer and international sensation Belinda Davids is currently in Cape Town doing a tribute show called The Greatest Love of All. In preparation for that, she had an impromptu intimate performance at Groote Schuur Hospital, loud enough for the staff and the patients to enjoy. If the response of the staff is anything to go by, the show is definitely something to look forward to. We had the privilege to sit down and have a chat with her, and here is what she had to say. First of all, thank you very much for taking the time to speak to us. You are back in South Africa now. First of all, how does that feel?
Amazing. It's always nice to come home. I get off the plane and it's so funny. I get off the plane and I look at everyone on the sides because the staff is there, and we are a very unique country.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Our people don't look like Americans. Our people don't look like people from Denmark or anyone in Europe. You know, we are very distinct, you know? It's always nice to get off the plane and see my people. It's always amazing.
You were talking about America now and overseas.
Yeah.
You have had the privilege to be on Britain's Got Talent,
yeah,
and some other competition as well, live at the Apollo.
Yeah.
How is that for you to represent yourself and also your country over there?
It's nerve-wracking, but it's quite... Excuse me, it's quite an experience because, you know, people don't understand. I'm not nervous to perform for people. I'm not nervous to have performed on BGT. I'm not nervous to perform for the Apollo. I'm nervous because I represent something much bigger than me. I'm nervous because I represent my country, my people. You know, that's why I get nervous, because I want to be perfect for them, you know, and make my country proud. That's why I get nervous. And it's a pleasure every time. It's a pleasure to go through all these experiences, you know, and show everyone what I'm doing. You know, I do this for you. I do this for you. I do this to show you that you can do anything at any... I'm 47. And let me tell you something. I won't stop until heaven knows when, you know. And I'm trying to tell everyone here that you don't have to stop when you get to a certain age. Keep going. Still live your dream. I want to be a doctor one day. Who says I'm not going to be? When I get to 60, maybe I'll go study and be a doctor. You know? Yeah. I represent my people.
Yeah. Okay, so I will come back to that one.
Yeah.
But you mentioned now, like, being a doctor, you can do that. Was singing always something that you wanted to do, or was it something else that, as you were growing up, oh, I wanted to be an accountant or a lawyer? Or has singing always been there for you?
I think I wanted to be a doctor. I'm not even kidding about that. I wanted to be a doctor because I saw how hard my sister studied to be a nurse. You know, and I was like, not just that, but I believe that I'm a natural healer. You know, naturally in me, I'm a healer. And so I've always wanted to be a doctor. Wanted to be a singer? That came naturally. That was just there, you know, and... why not grow up and perfect this talent that I got from God? Why not work on perfecting that? So, yes, I wanted to be a singer.
Okay. You mentioned that you go overseas or take part in the competitions to represent the country doing it for,
yeah,
us. We all know Simon Cowell, when it comes to the competitions, he's very blunt with his comments and all of those things. One of the things he did say about you, though, is, I absolutely adore you.
Yeah.
How was that performance before that?
It was great. It was a great experience. It was, you know, it was smack in the middle of COVID. I was lucky because I could travel. although it was a lot of paperwork, but I could travel. And so to be able to do that in such a difficult time was an absolute pleasure and a great experience. And to have him that way was a bit disappointing, actually, because everyone always said to me, he always really tough and he's really hard on the good ones. And I was like, well, why wasn't he hard on me? Then I learned he had a child and it made him soft. But still a great guy.
Okay. Is there, after that, is there anything that we can look forward to after that, before we come back to the greatest love of all on the 2nd of December?
Well, I have so many places that I'm yet to touch. So many countries that I have to go to. You have to understand, COVID was a bit of a difficult time for everybody. And so the world is trying to catch up, you know, for that loss. And so I'm doing the same thing. And we, you know, we made obligations. And so times are falling upon, you know, times are now for me to fulfill those obligations. And so I'm going to do that. But as far as original music is concerned, that's coming. That is definitely coming. But I feel like I need to get away from the show. I need to stop the show. I need to step away from it in order to give everyone amazing music, you know. I want to give them fresh and good and just amazing music.
And it's definitely something that we are looking forward to. For the young ones coming up, trying to break into the industry, and that, is there any message for them?
Always. There's always a message. The message is, this industry is so extremely hard, and if you have hair on your teeth, if you even dare grow any hair on your teeth, then you will not quit doing what you love. If it's in this industry, it's extremely hard. I'm not going to be cliche and say, oh, don't quit. Yeah, with the don't quit comes a lot of hard work. And if you are willing to do it, and with the right guidance and mentor, then you should do it. You should do it. And just persevere.
Belinda, thank you very much for your time. I'm sure there's still lots more things that I can ask you.
Yeah.
But for now, we will leave it at that and just say thank you for your time that you took to come and speak to us.
Thank you so much for having me.